It is not your fault for difficult Korean learning. Learn Korean anytime, anywhere. Salang Korean. Contents. Study Korean freely anytime, anywhere, without the concept of time and space. Classes starts immediately when you press the Start Class button. Choose a tutor that's right for you and study Korean.
Very good, very good. That was good. That was good. Super. Very good. That was very good. Super. Super. All right. So let's go to the next one. Okay, how are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
Yeah, I'm good as well. Thank you. Okay, so for today, we are going to learn this Korean song, which is called Fake Love. You got it?
Yes.
Okay, so what we are going to do for today is we're going to listen to the song first. You see the YouTube on the right? And then you're gonna learn the lyrics one by one, and then we are going to talk about some vocabulary and some grammar as well.
Okay.
All right, super. Okay. Let's listen to the first page, and then let's read the next part.
난 아파로.
Yes.
건강한 쪽 화소가 있었어.
Very good. That was really good. Alright, so it's really similar to the second line, right? So, 난, I, 아파도 is 아프다 means like to be sick, to hurt.
So, to hurt,
아파도,
right.
So we put the same 도, which means even if, even though. And then this 강한, which means strong. And then we also put 척, which means pretend. So even if I was hurt, I was like sad or something, I could pretend to be strong.
Okay.
We put the same thing, 할 수가 있었어, which means could.
Right.
All right. Mm-hmm. So we got the first page. Super, so good? Super. All right, so let's get to the next one. All right, so we are going to listen to this four pages one more time.
Okay.
Beginning. All right, one second. Here it goes.
토픽 그래머 클래스. I'm In-young, your Korean teacher. Today our topic is I can swim. So in this lecture, you may express what you can do or what you cannot do. So in Korean, 저는 수영을 할 수 있어요. So that means I can swim. So telephone-related verbs, let's take a look. So first, to make a phone call, 전화를 하다. So we use 하다 verb, 전화를 하다. 전화 is phone call or call. Or you can change 걸다, 걸다. So 전화를 걸다 or 전화를 하다. Phone is ringing. Oh, you saw that phone is ringing. So 전화가 오다. We used the 오다 to come verb for phone is ringing. 전화가 오다. Or ringing itself means 울리다. So 울리다. 전화가 울리다. 전화가 오다. So 전화가 오다 basically means incoming call. 울리다 is ringing. To answer the phone, 전화를 받다. So we use the receive verb. So 전화를 받다 to answer the phone. To send a text message, 문자를 보내다. 문자를 보내다. So to send is 보내다. 문자를 보내다. To receive a text. To receive a text. 문자를 받다. 문자를 받다. So 전화. Both 전화 and 문자 we use 받다. 문자를 지우다. You want to delete what you got. So 문자를 지우다. 지우다 is delete. 문자를 지우다. 통화하다. To be talking on the phone. To be talking on the phone. 통화하다. 통화하다. To have a wrong number. 전화를 잘못 걸다. So before we learn 걸다 verb. But if we put 잘못. 잘못 means wrong. So wrong number. I have a no, wrong number. 전화를 잘못 걸다. 전화를 바꿔주다. You want to talk to Jane, but the other person got her cell phone instead. So 전화를 바꿔주다. To give someone the phone. To give someone the phone. 바꿔주다. 전화를 끊다. So you talked, your talking and conversation is finished. So to hang up the phone, to hang up the phone, 전화를 끊다. So because of 히읗, so 니은 히읗, that is a double final consonant. So when you read loudly or when you pronounce 끊, so we should still keep the first final consonant 니은, and then 타, 끊다. So we still respect the aspiration. So 끊다 is right pronunciation. 전화를 끊다. So when you get the phone, hello in English, we say 여보세요 in Korea. 여보세요. Who is this calling? 누구세요? 자, 누구세요? Who are you? In reality, if you meet someone who's stranger, then you can say 누구세요 as well as And wait a minute, 잠깐만요, 잠깐만요. So, 여보세요, 누구세요? 잠깐만요. Here we have four different conjunctions. First, and, 그리고, 그리고. So, or that is why, 그래서, or therefore, 그래서. Then, in that case, 그러면, 그럼, same. 그러면 is longer version and 그럼 is short for 그러면. However, by the way, 그런데. 그런데. So from the beginning, 그리고, 그리고, 그래서, 그래서, 그러면 or 그럼. 그러면 or 그럼. 그런데, 그런데. So 누구, 그런데 누구세요? 그런데 누구세요? We frequently say that. 그런데 누구세요? Write the appropriate sentence in the blank as shown in the text, shown in the example. 자, 문자를 보냈어요. I sent. 자, 보냈어요. Already sent. So I sent a text message. 문자를 보냈어요. 오. So number one, which is 문자를 받았어요. The opposite situation. Now I received a message. 문자를 받았어요. In case you cannot see this one, I can write bigger. 삭제. So this is the alarm. 할까요? So cell phone is asking you by using this sentence. 삭제할까요? So do you want to delete? 문자를 지웠어요. So I used 지우다 as a verb. So which means to delete or to erase. So this is also 지우다. I just delete or erased 지우다. Because we should describe with the past tense 었어요. 었어요. Why? I saw vowel u. And 우 belongs to 었어요. And 우 and 어 can be matched, used together. So 지웠어요. Eventually becomes 지웠어요. So what? Please remember. Complete the dialogue as shown in the example. So here there are two people and they are talking on the phone. First, 여보세요. So say hello. 네, 누구세요? 누구세요? Who is this? Who's calling? 자, 누구세요? Again, 여보세요? Hello? 저는 제인입니다. This is Jane. 자, 저는 제인입니다. 민호 씨 좀, 민호 씨 좀. So, Jane wants to talk to 민호 on the phone. 바꿔주세요. But this person is not Minho. So she's thinking about his face here in the picture. So she wants to talk with Minho, but the receiver was not Minho. So we can say 바꿔주세요. 바꿔주세요. 바꾸다 is the verb to change. But in this case, she wants to talk to someone else. Which is Minho here. 바꿔주세요. And again, grammatical point. So, I can see the vowel 우 here. And 세요, 주세요. And then we all bring 어. Because we should change it to 주세요 to complete this sentence. Then, originally, 바꾸어 주세요, right? 어 주세요, 아 주세요. 바꾸어 주세요. Originally, you may ask me why I cannot write like this. But 꾸어 주세요, we already have double vowel as one set, 워. So we don't have to write like two times, 바꾸어 주세요, because we have like shortcut. 워 already existed in our alphabet. So 바꿔주세요 can be the right answer. Not 바꾸어주세요. 제인 씨 있어요? 아, 제인 씨 있어요? 있어요? 없어요? That means, can I talk to Jane? 있어요? Is there Jane? 어, 네. Yes. 잠깐만요. What does it mean by that? 잠깐만요. Wait a minute. Give me a second. 잠깐. 잠깐 as a noun, a moment. So, 제인 씨 전화 받으세요. So, this person first talk to the person who is on the phone. 네, 잠깐만요. Okay, give me a second. And then she turned to Jane. And, 아, 제인 씨 전화 받으세요. So, please divide the two sentences. Because in this situation, this person, let's say, 나 is 수진. 수진 is talking to the person on the phone. And then, 제인 씨, she calls, 수진 called Jane to change, to give her cell phone. 전화 받으세요. 자, 세요 is suggestion. 세요, why don't you please get? So, 수진 is talking to two persons. One is the person who is on the phone, and later she talks to Jane directly. Okay, number three. 거기 제인 씨 기숙사예요? 거기 제인 씨 기숙사예요? So here we can guess, 제인 씨의 기숙사예요. So dormitory of Jane or Jane's dormitory. But in Korean language, sometimes we just omit 의. Unless you just still conveying its meaning, so we can just omit 의, but because we still understand it's Jane's dormitory, not anyone else. So 제인 씨 기숙사예요? So he's calling to the dormitory office maybe, and then he's looking for Jane. But the clerk or the person who is in that dormitory, she said, 아니에요. 잘못 거셨어요. 잘못 means wrong. 걸다. 걸다 was original form. To make a phone call, 걸다. However, we still should use past tense. 걸다. Then we keep 거 and omit 리을. 거시다. Why? Because they are strangers. They want to use honorific word. 잘못 거시다. 거시다 is honorific word of 걸다. 거시다. Then now we have E vowel. And E always belong to 없어요. 없어요. So 거셨어요. So it changed like two stages. First, 걸다 was original form. But we want to make it honorific way because they are strangers each other. So 걸다 came changed it to 거시다, which is honorific way of speaking of 걸다. And then we should take a look its grammar. And she, we have e vowel here, and e always usually belong to 오셨어요, 왔어요, that all vowel. But still, we should put 셨어요. That's the part that you should memorize. 거셨어요. So 거기 제인 씨 기숙사예요? 아니에요. 잘못 거셨어요. 죄송합니다. I'm sorry. I apologize. So grammar one, 뭐뭐 할 수 있다 없다, 을 수 있다 없다. So as I already introduced during the opening, I said, 나는 수영을 할 수 있다. So I told you our purpose of this lecture is describe what can you do or what you cannot do. So 을 수 없다 or 있다. So 있다, 없다. We can describe as our capacity. So for example, 한국어를 할 수 있다. I can speak Korean, but this is original form of verb. We don't say 할 수 있다 in reality when you speak to someone. So 있어요, we should change it to complete this sentence. 한국어를 할 수 있어요. So 하다 verb has been used here. And 다 can be omitted. And then 르 or 을. Either 을 수 있다 or 르. So, it's also a matter of final consonant. 가다, as always, a representative of verb which doesn't have any final consonant, then we bring 를. 수 있다, 갈 수 있어요. 먹다, representative of verb which doesn't have any does have final consonant. 을 수 없다, 먹을 수 없어요. So, I can go, I cannot eat. 먹을 수 없어요, 갈 수 있어요. So if you can ride a bicycle, 자전거를 탈 수 있어요, 타다. Same as 가다, doesn't have any final consonant. 타 should need 르, 탈, 탈 수 있어요 because you can ride 있어요, 탈 수 있어요. If you can play the piano, we can say 피아노를 칠 수 있어요. 치다, to play, especially piano. So 치다, yes, we don't have any final consonant, so 칠, 리을 should be added. 칠 수 있어요 because this is available. It means available. I cannot. Now negation. I cannot eat spicy food. 매운 음식을 먹을 수 없어요. 먹다. Yes, we have final consonants, so we don't need the liers help. So 먹을 수 없어요. We should bring the whole thing. 먹을 수 없어요. 있어요. So I am not really good at eating spicy food. I cannot eat spicy food. 매운 음식을 먹을 수 없어요. 열심히 공부하면 좋은 점수를 받을 수 있어요. 자, 뭐뭐 하면, 면, if you study hard, 열심히. 자, hard is 열심히. You can get good grades. 좋은 점수를 받을 수 있어요. 자, get, to get is 받다. Pad has final consonant, so we just bring the whole thing. 받을 수 있어요. Good. So 중국어를 할 수 있어요? Can you speak Chinese? 할 수 있다. 하다. 하다 verb has been used. But this time, because we are talking about availability, so we don't put like 해요 this time. So don't think about 했어요, 하다, that grammar. So we only consider final consonant. So 할 수 있어요, we should bring 리을. So 할 수 있어요 because she or he can speak Chinese. Oh, the answer is no, I can. 아니요, 할 수 없어요. 뭐뭐를 할 수 없어요. This is object. 뭐뭐를 할 수 없어요. 중국어를 할 수 없어요. 한국어를 할 수 있어요? 아니요, 한국어를 할 수 없어요. 일본어를 할 수 있어요? 아니요, 일본어를 할 수 없어요. So any language can be placed like Japanese, Chinese, Korean, and English. So by the way, 한국어, 일본어, 영어, English is 영어, and 중국어, Chinese. So we can put any language like Spanish, Spaino. This is just for your information. Spaino, 러시아어. Good. 내일 만날 수 있어요? 아, 만나다 has been used. And let's take a look. 어, 나 doesn't have any final consonant here, so we should bring 리을. 만날 수 있어요? Can we meet tomorrow? 아니요. No, I can't. 내일 수업이 있어서 만날 수 없어요. 없어요. So, 뭐뭐 할 수 없어요. 할 수 있어요. 리을. Please be careful. 자, 내일, tomorrow, 수업이, classes, 있다. I have classes. 그래서 만날 수 없어요. So first verb is 추다, to dance. So we can ask you, can you dance? And then you may answer, 네, 출 수 있어요. 아, 출 수 없어요. So 추다 doesn't have any final consonant. We should bring 리을, 출 수 있어요. And let's take a look, 치다. 치다 was used when we describe I can play the piano. So, 칠 수 있어요. 칠 수 있어요. And three, 타다. 버스를 타요. 택시를 타요. To take. 탈 수 있어요. Because these are all no final consonant. So, 탈 수 있어요 or 탈 수 없어요. Now we are using negation. 어, 먹다. 먹을 수 없어요. 매운 음식 먹을 수 없어요. 듣다. Special mark. So, 디귿. Change it to 리을. Then, 들을 수 없어요. 들을 수 없어요. I cannot hear you. 들을 수 없어요. 만들 수 없어요. 만들 수 없어요. So, 만들다, just delete 다, and 수 없어요, 만들 수 없어요. This time, we don't use 을, because we already had the vowel 으 in 만들다, so just naturally goes to 만들다. We don't have to change it. So, 보기, example. 자, 수영을 할 수 있어요? Can you swim? 네, 수영을 할 수 있어요. Yes, I can swim. 아니요, 수영을 할 수 없어요. No, I cannot swim. So, 있어요? 없어요. 있어요? Can you? 없어요? Can't you? Number one, 테니스를 칠 수 있어요? 자, 치다, play. So, can you play the tennis? 자, 테니스 칠 수 있어요? Tennis is the English word tennis. 네, 테니스를 칠 수 있어요? If you cannot play tennis, 아니요, 테니스를 칠 수 없어요. Number two, 운전을 할 수 있어요? 운전하다. 운전 is drive, to drive. 운전하다. This is original verb. 네, 운전을 할 수 있어요. 운전을 할 수 있어요. Yes, I can drive. No, I cannot drive. 운전을 할 수 없어요. Number three, 매운 음식을 먹을 수 있어요? 먹을 수 있어요? 네, 매운 음식 좋아해요. 매운 음식을 먹을 수 있어요. No, I cannot eat some spicy food. 매운 음식을 먹을 수 없어요. 먹다 is not that difficult. So, 할 수 있다. 자, 할 수 있다 can or cannot do. So, well, 하다 verb has been used. Oh, this is our grammar point two. 못, 못. So, 못 itself means not. So, I don't, that not. I do not, I cannot. So, this is not. 저는 술을 못 마셔요. 저는 술을 못 마셔요. I cannot drink 소주. 저는 I cannot drink. Here we have 소주. I cannot drink alcohol. 저는 술을 못 마셔요. So 못 가다, 못 가요. 못 먹다, 못 먹어요. 못 공부를 하다. And at this point, we should put 못 here. 공부를 못 해요. So later of noun and object. So here, 공부를 is object. So we should put 못해요 here, like before 하다. So 못 가요. I cannot go. So for example, let's say your friend asks you to go to the mountain together. Oh, 저는 못 가요 because I have a test tomorrow. 저는 시험이 있어서 내일 등산에 못 가요. What if your friend suggested, oh, let's eat some spicy food. Oh, but you are not really good at eating spicy food. So, 미안해요. 저는 매운 음식을 못 먹어요. I cannot eat or I cannot stand with spicy food. 공부를 못해요. That means your grade, GPA is not really good. So 공부를 못해요. 아, 우리 아이는 공부를 못해요. My child, his or her GPA grades are not really good. They're very low. 공부를 못해요. 자, 못 가요. This person couldn't go somewhere. 자, 학교에 못 가요. I cannot go to school because I'm sick. 몸이 아파서. 자, 뭐뭐 해서. The reason why. Because I am sick, I cannot go to school. 자, 먹지 못해요. 뭘 먹지 못해요? Cannot eat what? Spicy food. 자, 저는 매운 음식을 먹지 못해요. I can eat spicy food. We don't know the reason why here. 자, 잠을 못 잤어요. 자, here the signal of past tense. 자다 is original verb. 잤어요. Past tense. 자, 잤어요. But couldn't sleep well. 자, 못 잤어요. Here we need 못. Negation. 못 잤어요. Yesterday or last night. 어제 잠을 못 잤어요. 자, 하지 못했어요. 자, 하다. But 했어요 is past tense. 했어요. But that means did. You already did. But in this sentence, 못했어요. Didn't. I couldn't go. Yeah, I couldn't or didn't go shopping yesterday. 하지 못했어요. 쇼핑을 자, 어제 가지 못했어요. So let's take a look more examples. Can we see movie together tomorrow? 우리 같이 내일 영화 볼 수 있어요? 자, 내일 같이 together 영화를 볼 수 있어요? 자, 보다. 보다 doesn't have a final consonant. 볼 수 있어요 is the right answer. 자, 영화를 같이 볼 수 있어요. 자, this person asked, oh, let's watch the movie together. But the answer was, no, I can't. 자, 못 봐요, 못 봐요. 봐요. 자, if you told, 봐요. That means, yes, we can go together, but 못 봐요 because of 못. This is like a refusal. 못 봐요. Why? I'm too busy. I'm 너무 바빠서 to see a movie. 자, 영화를 보기에는 너무 바빠서 내일 갈 수 없어요. 못 봐요. Why didn't you answer the phone? 왜 전화를 안 받았어요? This person may try to call her. 왜 전화 안 받았어요? I couldn't answer the phone because I was in the class. 못 봤다. 자, if we say 봤다. She received his phone call. 자, 받다. 받았다. That's past tense. 받았다. She already received. She already answered. However, we put 못 받았다. She couldn't. Or she didn't. But usually couldn't because 못하다 versus 안하다. There was no choice in 못. 안하다. You chose not to answer that phone. So 안 받았다, for example, this is another grammar point, but let's just take a look the difference between 못 and 안. 안 받았다, that means she didn't want to. She chose not to answer that phone. However, 못 받았다 is like there is no choice but to do something because she was in the class. She couldn't decide anything because it's just not available. So 못 is can't. 안 is don't. And you may choose, you cannot choose. So 수업이 있어서 못 받았어요. So let's practice. So we have verb 가다 to go. 못 못 가요. Since we have vowel a here, we should find something very similar, which is 아요 instead of 어요. 못 만날까요? That's the right answer. And 못 만나요. 못 만나요. 만나다 to meet. Again, 아 vowel. And we chose 아요. 못 만나요. So, 못 is still the same. 먹다 to eat. 못 먹어요. 못 먹어요. So, a vowel can be followed by 어요. 못 먹어요. 마시다 to drink. 뭐뭐 하지 못해요. So, 마시다 doesn't follow 아요 or 어요 grammar. 지 못해요. 마시지 못해요. 뭐뭐 하지 못해요. So, we put 지 here. And 못해요. 하다 verb. By using 하다. So, 못하다. 마시는 the action to drink. 마시는 행동을 못하다. 마시지 못해요. 읽다. 읽지 못해요. 읽지 못해요. I cannot read. So, 못하다. Also, original verb of 못해요. 운전하지 못해요. 지. 운전하지 못해요. 운전하지 못하다. That was original form of 못해요. So, please remember. Just 못 가요. 가지 못해요. We can say that too. 가지 못해요. So, there are two different styles. So, if you want to put verb first, then you should put 지. 가지 못해요. 마시지 못해요. But if you want to put negation first, 못 마셔요. Either way is okay. The same, totally same meaning. So, 마시지 못해요. So, verb first. 못 마셔요. 못 first. But the meaning is the same. 마시지 못해요. 못 마셔요. Then what about 읽다? 읽지 못해요. 못 읽어요. 운전하지 못해요. But this is exception. Like, we don't say 못 운전해요. It's kind of difficult to pronounce. So, we don't talk like this. 못 운전해요. Don't think about it. And 못 만나요. So, if we want to put verb first, 만나지 못해요. So, just like put 지 못해요. And if we want to put verb first here, then 먹 and put 지 못해요. But still, we can say 못 먹어요 as well. So, the meaning are the totally same. 못 먹어요, 먹지 못해요. 왜 고향이 안 가요? Why you don't go back to your hometown? 고향에 왜 안 가요? 일이 많아서, 자, 뭐뭐 해서, because, the reason why. 일이 많기 때문에, there are a lot of things to do. 고향에 못 가요. 자, 가지 못해요. Same. The difference is putting 못 first or putting the verb first. 일이 많아서 고향에 못 가요. 일이 많아서 고향에 가지 못해요. Same. 늦잠을 자다. To get up late. 자, 늦잠을 잤어요. 자, why didn't you come to school? 어제 학교에 안 왔어요. She skipped the school. 늦잠을 자서 학교에 못 갔어요. So here, 못 first and verb later. 늦잠을 자서 학교에 가지 못했어요. Verb first, 못했어요. 못하다 later. Why 못하다 is the one set? Because all the verb we cannot do. So 하다 is do. So, if you put negation right in front of do, that means you didn't, you couldn't do it. 가지 못했어요. And past tense. Because this conversation is talking about yesterday. And the next adjective is 아프다. 아프다. To get sick. 왜 요즘 운동을 안 해요? 자, 요즘 is these days. Recently. Why recently you don't exercise? 자, 왜 요즘 운동을 안 해요? 자, 안 means why you don't. So you still have the right of making a decision. But actually, she has no choice because 아파서 운동을 못해요. Or 아파서 운동을 하지 못해요. So, 못 has placed first. Or 운동을 하다. The verb has placed first. And then putting 못해요. 시험이 있다. Have a class. 주말에 같이 영화를 볼까요? This person asked, why don't we watch movie on this weekend together? 자, 주말에 같이 영화를 볼까요? Shall we? 자, suggestion. 그런데 시험이 있어서, again, 아파서 있어서, the reason why. 자, 영화를 못 봐요. 못 has been placed first and 봐요. 시험이 있어서 영화를 보지 못해요. 자, 보다, the verb placed first and then 못해요. So it's the same meaning. 자, 영화를 못 봐요. 영화를 보지 못해요. Yes, here is our final grammar point for today. 뭐뭐 하기 때문에. I already mentioned the reason, the description of talking your reason why you cannot do this action. So 뭐뭐 해서, 아파서, 있어서. So another way of express the reason is 뭐뭐 하기 때문에. 자, 때문에 due to or sometimes thanks to. Due to something, I couldn't do something. Due thanks to something, I could do something. 자, 비가 오기 때문에 등산을 갈 수 없어요. Negative one. 자, 비가 오기 때문에, 비가 오다 is our verb here. But this also a reason why I couldn't go to climbing mountain. 자, 비가 오다 because it rained, I couldn't go to the climbing mountain. So, due to. 자, 가다 plus 기 때문에. Good thing is 기 때문에 is always the same. 가다, 없다, 먹다. You can use everything here in front. So, 가기 때문에 because I go. Due to I'm going. 없기 때문에 because there isn't. Due to it's not existing. 없기 때문에. So, let's take a look more examples. I want to take a rest in the dormitory because I am sick. Oh, because here and then 뭐뭐 하기 때문에. 자, because I'm sick. 머리가 아프기 때문에 기숙사에서 쉬고 싶어요. 자, 뭐뭐 하고 싶어요. 싶다. I want to usually 하고 싶다. 자, 뭐 하고 싶어요? What do you want to do? 쉬고 싶어요. To take a rest. 자, 왜요? Why? 머리가 아프기 때문에. Because I'm sick. So, 뭐뭐 하기 때문에 is always the reason and then why you feel like this. And next one. 요즘, recently, 아르바이트를 하기 때문에 좀 바빠요. 자, 아르바이트 is a part-time job. Since I have a part-time job these days, 좀 바빠요. I'm a little busy. 조금 바빠요. So this is reason why you are busy recently. The reason is having a part-time job. I can't watch a movie because I have exams tomorrow. 자, 내일 시험이 있기 때문에. 자, tomorrow, 내일. Since I have a test tomorrow. 자, since, 자, 뭐뭐 하기 때문에 영화를 볼 수 없어요. 영화를 보지 못해요. All okay. I often eat 삼계탕 because it is good for the health. 자, 삼계탕은 건강에 좋기 때문에. 삼계탕 is the name of food of Korea. 자, 삼계탕은 건강에 좋기 때문이니까, 좋으니까, or 좋아서. 자, 자주 먹어요. That's why I eat this food often. 자, so please remember 뭐뭐 하기 때문에 is the reason why of the following part of sentence. This is the result, but this is the reason why it became. So please remember. Okay, let's take a look at the two different dialogues. 오늘 학교에 가요? Do you go to school today? 자, 오늘 학교에 가요? 아, 아니요, 오늘은 수업이 없기 때문에. Because I don't have any class today. 자, 오늘은 수업이 없어요. 그래서 that's why 학교에 안 가요. I don't go to school today. 자, 왜 그 식당에 자주 가요? 왜 is why. Why do you often go to the restaurant? What's the reason? 자, 왜? 이유를 물어보고 있죠. I often go to the restaurant. 말했어요. I often. This is the Result. I go to that restaurant very often. Why? 아, 그 식당은 음식이 맛있기 때문이에요. Because the food is very delicious. 자, 그 식당은 음식이 맛있기 때문에 저는 자주 가요. So, 때문에. So, it doesn't matter if it's negative reason or positive reason. Because 음식이 맛있다 is quite, sounds very positive. So, 때문에 is also can be used. 없기 때문에, 수업이 없기 때문에, there's no positive and negative things. So, 때문에 is always talking about the reason. So, due to. 오다, 비가 오기 때문에 오늘 등산을 못 갔어요. 자, 오다, 오기 때문에. 자, next one, 먹기 때문에. So, C doesn't matter of its final consonant. So, just put기 때문에. Very lucky. 있기 때문에. 있기 때문에, because there are or there is. 자, 크다, large or to be big. 크기 때문에, 크기 때문에, see? So, same, 기 때문에. 아, 막, 예를 들어, for example, 이 TV가, 자, TV가 크기 때문에 들어가지 않아요. 자, 들어가지 않아요. We can describe like that. 들어가지 않아요. So, the people try to put TV into the room, but because TV is too big, 자, 크기가 너무 크기 때문에 들어가지 않아요. Something like this. The reason why we cannot put the TV into the room is because 크기 때문에. 자, 많다. 많다. As I already mentioned, 자, 많다 is be careful with its pronunciation. 만, we should still keep 만. And because 흐 is 흐 sound. And that means aspiration. You can feel more wind from your mouth. So 타, 많다 is the right pronunciation. Anyway, 많기 때문에. 자, 오늘은 내일은 시험이 많기 때문에. Since, due to, because I have lots of tests tomorrow. 아, 오늘 밤은 잘 수 없어요. 잘 수 없어요. I cannot fall asleep. 오늘은 내일 시험이 너무 많기 때문에 오늘은 잘 수 없어요. 공부해야 해요. 자, 좋다. To be good. 좋기 때문에. 아, 그 물건이 that goods. 자, 물건이 or 상품이 that products. 물건이 좋기 때문에 아, 사버렸어요. 샀어요. That's why I bought it. 너무 좋았기 때문에 샀어요. So, 샀어요. That's the result. And this is reason why you bought that product. So here we have one more practice to complete the dialogue. So here, 수업이 없다. She's very relaxed. She's chilling because she doesn't have any classes. 자, 오늘 뭐 해요? What are you doing? Or what do you do today? 자, 오늘은 수업이 없기 때문에 아, result. I'm taking a rest. I am chilling. 자, 쉬고 있어요. 자, this is ing. She is currently chilling. 쉬고 있어요. Because 없기 때문에 she doesn't have any classes. 자, number one. 자, 식당. Wow, look at that line. Everyone is waiting for the restaurant. 자, 음식이 맛있다. This is what we should use. 음식이 맛있다. The food is delicious. 자, 이 식당은 왜 이렇게 emphasize? Why? Why so many? Why there are so many customers in this restaurant? 자, 손님 is customers. So, the reason why there are so many people in the line is 음식이 맛있기 때문에. This is the result. 손님이 많아요. There are a lot of customers. 자, 그 음식이 맛있기 때문에. Again, 때문에 doesn't matter of negative and positive. Because 음식이 맛있다, that is positive one. Number two, 열심히 공부하다. Study hard, 열심히 공부하다. Wow, because Jane speaks Korean very fluently, the speaker wants to know how come you can speak Korean that very well. 자, 제인 씨는 어떻게 한국말을 잘해요? Because this is the reason why she can speak Korean very well. 열심히 공부하기 때문에, which is studying hard. 한국말을 잘해요. Good. Number three. 자, 친구가 집에 오다. Who's coming? My friends are coming to my house. 자, 왜 이렇게 음식을 많이 준비했어요? Why did you prepare so much food? 왜 이렇게 음식을 많이, so much, too much 준비했어요? Prepare. But 했어요 is past tense. Why did you prepare? 자, 왜 그렇게 음식을 많이 준비했어요? 왜 이렇게? That is why plus emphasize. 왜 이렇게? Then, 친구가 because the reason why I prepare so much food is my friends are coming. 친구가 집에 오기 때문에 저는 음식을 많이 준비했어요. So, please remember 뭐뭐 하기 때문에. So, let's review. Today we learned some vocabularies and expressions related to phone call. First, 전화를 하다. To make a phone call to someone. 전화를 하다. 전화를 걸다. Same, same. 제가 전화를 걸게요. 제가 전화를 할게요. All same. And opposite situation. I'm the receiver. So 전화가 오다. 전화를 받다. 전화가 오다. So please be careful with 가를. 전화가 오다. Because the phone calling is coming, incoming calls. That's why we used 가. But I'm the one who received the phone calls. That's why 전화를 받다. Please be, consider the 가 or 를. And then 보내다, to send text message, 문자를 보내다. 자, 문자 means number one characters like these letters. That's 문자. Letter is also 문자, but on the cell phone, that means a text message. So 보내다 is to send, 받다 is to receive. 문자를 받다, 문자를 보내다. And now you want to delete it, 지우다. 문자를 지우다, delete the text message. 전화를 잘못 걸다. 자, 못 is not, negation. So 잘못 걸다, you have a wrong number. 잘못 걸다, 전화를 바꿔주다. So for example, you want to talk with Jane, but someone else received your phone call, like Minho. So you want to talk with Jane. So asking, oh, can I talk with Jane? To Minho. You ask to Minho. So 전화를 바꿔주다. 전화 좀 바꿔주세요. 전화를 끊다. Hang the phone call. 전화를 끊다. So be careful with the pronunciation because it's double final consonant, N and H. So, H aspiration, we still should keep it. So, it can't be 끊다, 끊다. So, this is only for your pronunciation. Please don't write when you describe 끊다. This is right spelling, but think about the pronunciation. 끊다 and 끊다. 자, 을 수 있다, 없다, availability. Can you ride the bicycle? Can you eat spicy food? 자전거를 탈 수 있어요. 타다. Because 타 doesn't have any final consonant, we brought 를. And 먹다. Because we have final consonant, we just brought 을 수 없어요 or 있어요. So, 못. Not. 못 가요? 가지 못해요. Same. So, the only difference is putting which one put first. 못 가요? 가요? And then 못하다. This is the rule. So if you want to put the not negation first, then 못 가요. But if you want to put verb first, then 가 and then put 못하다. So 못해요. So 다 못해요. Since we are completing the sentence. 어제 쇼핑을 하지 못했어요. 자, then we can change to 못했어요. 아, 못 갔어요. 어제 쇼핑을 못 갔어요. Or just 못했어요. Because I want to put 못 first. The meaning are all same. 어제 쇼핑을 하지 못했어요. 자, 하다 verb placed first. 어제 쇼핑을 못 갔어요. I couldn't go. 어제 쇼핑을 못했어요. I couldn't do. Now we are talking about the reason why I couldn't do this, all things. 자, 뭐뭐 하기 때문에. So luckily we don't have to think about consonant, final consonant or anything. Just 기 때문에 is one set, just put it. 요즘 아르바이트를 하기 때문에 the reason why I am busy recently is because having a part-time job. Reason why I cannot watch the movie is because I have test tomorrow. 자, 내일 시험이 있기 때문에 영화를 볼 수 없어요. So the result can be actually should be placed the last part and then the reason should be the first place. 내일 시험이 있기 때문에 영화를 볼 수 없어요. 자, 몸이 아팠기 때문에 학교에 갈 수 없어요. 쇼핑을 하지 못했기 때문에 슬펐어요. I'm sad because I couldn't go to shopping. So like this, you can make sentences as you wish. So just remember, 자, 못 should be placed first. And if you want to change the verb first, then 지 못했어요. And please just remember 기 때문에 is always the same, not changeable. So reason first and then result. Reason first and then result. 뭐뭐 하기 때문에 just same grammar point. So don't think about like final consonant as well as 못. So this is pretty much for today. And thank you for watching my video. I will see you next time. Bye!
If you take classes while looking at the textbook with your tutor, your Korean speaking skills will improve. Meet Sailang's various Korean learning contests, such as business, token, and free talking. Get everything you want. Sailang has it all. Study Korean with Sailang. Study Korean anytime.